The new goal is to move to a sustainable energy future. We want to use energy sources that will be good for a billion years. How do we accelerate this transition? And what happens if we don't? So if we wait, and if we delay the change, the best case is simply delaying that inevitable transition to sustainable energy. So this is the best case if we don't take action now. At the risk of being repetitive, there's going to be no choice in the long term to move to sustainable energy. It's tautological. We have to have sustainable energy or we'll simply run out of the other one. The only thing we gain by slowing down the transition is just slowing it down. It doesn't make it not occur, it just slows it down. The worst case, however, is more displacement and destruction than all the wars in history combined. We have about 3% of scientists that believe in the best case, and about 97% that believe in the worst case. This is why I call it the dumbest experiment in history, ever. Like, why would you do this? The reason that the transition is delayed or is happening slowly is because there is a hidden subsidy on all carbon-producing activity. In a healthy market, if you have, say, 10 euros of benefit and 4 euros of harm to society, the profit would be 6 euros. This sort of makes obvious sense. This is where the incentives are aligned with a good future. This is not the case today. But if you have the incentives aligned, then the forcing function towards a good future, towards a sustainable energy future, will be powerful. In an unhealthy market, you have your 10 euros of benefit, the 4 euros isn't taxed, so you have an untaxed negative externality. This is basically economics 101. So you have basically unreasonable profit and a forcing function to do carbon-emitting activity because this cost to society is not being paid. The net result is 35 gigatons of carbon per year into the atmosphere. This is analogous to not paying for garbage collection. It's not as though we should say, in the case of garbage, have a garbage-free society. It's very difficult to have a garbage-free society, but it's just important that people pay for the garbage collection. So we need to go from having an untaxed negative externality, which is effectively a hidden carbon subsidy of enormous size, $5.3 trillion a year, according to the IMF, every year. We need to move away from this and have a carbon tax. This is being fought quite hard by the carbon producers. And they're using tactics that are very similar to what the cigarette industry used for many years. Even though the overwhelming scientific consensus was that smoking cigarettes was bad for you, they would find a few scientists that would disagree, and then they would say, look, scientists disagree. That's essentially how they would try to trick the public into thinking that smoking is not that bad. The solution, obviously, is to remove the subsidy. So that means we need to have a carbon tax, and to make it sort of something which is neither a left nor a right issue, we should make it probably a revenue-neutral carbon tax. So this would be a case of increasing taxes on carbon, but then reducing taxes in other places. So maybe there would be a reduction in sales tax or VAT, and an increase in carbon tax, so that only those using high levels of carbon would pay an increased tax. In order to give industry time to react, this could be a phased-in approach, so that maybe it takes 5 years before the carbon taxes are very high, so that means that only companies that don't take action today will suffer in 5 years. But there needs to be a clear message from government in this regard, because the fundamental problem is the rules today incent people to create carbon. This is madness, and whatever you incent will happen. That's why we're seeing very little effect thus far. And depending upon what action we take, we'll drive the carbon number to either extreme or moderate levels. I think it's pretty much a given that the 2°C increase will occur. The question is whether it's going to be much more than that, not if there will be a 2-degree increase. So what can you do? I would say whenever you have the opportunity, talk to your politicians, ask them to enact a carbon tax. We have to fix the unpriced externality. I would talk to your friends about it and fight the propaganda from the carbon industry. Thank you.